Christian Gay, we rolling? Hold on, let me replay this back. This that new Richie Lee, all right? Hold on, let me play. Turn me up, Gucci. All right, guys, welcome to another episode. We still do not have a name for this segment yet, but there was a lot of good ones in the comments on the first one, man. Hold on, let me turn down the new track. We do not have a new name for the segment yet. A lot of good ones in the comments on the first episode, though. There was like, I saw Beanie Talk. I saw Richie Rundown had a lot of likes on that one. We got This Is Not a Podcast. We got That's a Heavy Statement. There was a lot of good ones. I have not taken the proper time yet to decide what we are actually going to be calling this kind of like a new, you know, I would say new format, you know what I mean? But we're still working on it. You know, we're figuring out the kinks and everything. Shout out to David and Andrew, the Phone Bros, for recommending this Rodecaster Pro right here. This has... What would you call this, Gucci?
A soundboard.
A soundboard. Has, like, all these different sound effects, you know, like... You know, the pew-pew-pew is one of my favorite. We got the... Hold on. Let me...
Bruh.
So we could do a ton of things on this. You know, we got the okay. What else we got? We got the buzzer. Got the okay. That's a classic right there. So you know, we're gonna be playing around with this a lot. We got a lot of stuff to go over today. Project Goods is still happening. We had to reschedule it for this Friday, 8 a.m. It will be happening, and I added a ton of stuff to the website for you guys. The T Scotts will be added to the website. A lot of people were asking me if I'm going to be selling these, the Travis Scott ones. For the audience, for the fans, we are actually going to be selling these size 9. These might be the sneaker of the year. What do you guys think? So the Travis Scotts will... My bad. The Travis Scotts actually made the bruh sound happen. The Travis Scotts will be for sale. I think Ralph, which is our photographer for the Richie Lee collection, is going to be adding some sneakers and clothing. He is a size 11 and a half or 12, I think. So he's going to be adding stuff. Tan has some size 10s in there. So if you are, you know, on the bigger side, bigger shoe size, there will be some stuff for you guys. And I just want to let you guys know, Friday, it is happening, 8 a.m. PST. Pacific time. Right now we got the pick of the day. You know what I told you guys last time? We're always going to be showing you guys the pick of the day, you know, something that I just picked up or that I might recommend. These are actually from Uniqlo. You guys know how I feel about Uniqlo, man. I'm a big supporter of Uniqlo. Really quality essentials for pretty affordable prices. These are $14 each, and these are actually those really thick t-shirts that I recommended in the summer, but now they are offered in a very boxy fit. And the quality is crazy. If you see these in person, you're gonna know what I'm talking about. It is very thick, and it does have a pocket right here, and the boxy fit is a very nice boxy fit. Nothing too crazy, nothing too drapey or cropped or anything, but this is the black one. It comes out in a ton of different colors, so we got a black one right here. Very clean, like I said, $14. Not a bad essential to have in your wardrobe. And these are offered right now. And usually with Uniqlo, they do not keep everything year round. Usually, like I would say, they keep everything on their shelves for maybe a few months. So just keep that in mind if you guys are interested. The white one's right here. Nice boxy fit, you know, and the bottom right here has like a cut in the middle inseam right here. So it is, you know, some small details that separate it from a regular t-shirt. But the quality, like I said, is crazy on these. So $14, I'll leave the link in the description box for you guys if you're interested in copying the boxy thick, what do they call these? They call these the oversized crew neck short sleeves, 100% cotton, so they will shrink. So keep that in mind. All right, so the next pickup I gotta show you guys, man. I don't know how long I've been searching for this hat. You guys remember I did this video where I explained to you guys that I actually bought this hat from a website which was called 3PLA, which is kind of like a consignment shop. I bought the hat from them, and then they actually refunded me, and Big Sean himself actually bought the hat. Like, he basically carjacked me. I had the hat, I bought it and everything, and Big Sean was seen with it a few days later. I know Big Sean actually bought the hat that I purchased because he's friends with the owners of 3peat, but I had to give Big Sean a bro for that one, you know what I mean? But this is a hat right here, Bape Cause. I have no idea when this came out, but this is one of my favorite hats of all time. Kind of like a collector's item, I would say nowadays. And shout out to Bobby the Plug, man. If you guys are looking for some rare OG Bape and Supreme and all that, make sure you guys hit up Bobby the Plug on Instagram. He definitely hooked this up right here. I hit him up. He could have got probably, I don't even know, probably 10 times the amount that I paid. He probably could have got 10 times the amount, but he hooked that up. So we got the Cause Bape right here. Big Sean is always seen rocking the one that I purchased. Shout out to Big Sean, though. Still one of my favorite rappers. All right, so shout out to Bobby, man, with the real nice packaging straight from Japan. Woo! This hat is crazy. I don't know how long I've been searching for this hat, and anytime that I see it on Grailed or eBay, this hat fetches, like, I would say into the thousands, but it is brand new. I got it for, I don't want to say, but shout out to Bobby, man. Real crazy design. Every time that these are manufactured and produced, they come out in a unique design and pattern. So this one is really nice. Has the shooting Bape stars right here at the bottom and everything. Just a real nice hat. I wanted to, you know, show some love back to Bobby the Plug. Thank you for hooking this one up. All right, so we went over some products. We got the Travis Scott's Will Be For Sale for Project Goods, the t-shirts. We got the Cause hat. What else we got? All right, so right now we are going to be doing a hot take on some hot subjects right now. Hold on, let me turn down the J. Cole. All right, so Lonzo Ball, he is officially on the clock right now. All eyes on Lonzo, which he's really used to. But I'll watch this clip right now of ESPN to kind of give you guys some context. But he is parting ways with the BBB. You guys know how we feel about BBB, man.
About Foster's criminal past, and because Foster hasn't adequately accounted for the whereabouts of roughly $1.5 million.
Alan, if you guys don't know, he is like a co-founder of BBB, family friend of the Balls.
Now, Foster has been a friend of Lonzo's father, LeVar, for almost a decade and owns 16.3% of the Big Baller Brand. Lonzo owns 51% of Big Baller Brand. On Saturday night, Lonzo posted an Instagram picture with the slogan...
If Lonzo owns 51, Allen owns 16, probably LeVar owns like 20. What about the boy LaMelo, man? Would you guys give LaMelo 2%? I know you guys probably gave Jello probably 1%. That's why Jello ain't...
It's no. Only a crazy Jello, man. I don't want to clown Jello. Do it, where the caption reads, moving on to bigger and better, hashtag my own man.
All right, guys, so basically the news is Allen Foster, which is, I mean, he's always with LeVar and Lonzo and everything. He actually cannot tell their accountant where $1.5 million went. So that is a story that is emerging right now. You know, there's a lot of information still coming out and everything.
I'm starting the timer for the hot take.
All right, so the hot take timer right here where I give my opinion. Okay, BBB. I just hope that Lonzo can kind of become that player that we all thought he would become after all of this, man. Maybe moving on to Nike might be a new chapter for him. Maybe there's a lot of speculation of like even LaMelo, Jello deleting photos of them and their dad and everything on Instagram. I just hope this is a new chapter. I'm rooting for Lonzo. I actually like Lonzo and his game and everything. I know a lot of people don't, but for myself, I like it. You know, I sometimes watch the Ball Family. I mean, when it comes to Lonzo, didn't he like roll his ankle three times in the Lonzo Ball sneakers, the ZO2s? Like, that's crazy.
Lakers did say that his injury is because of BBB shoes.
There you go. Like, he needs to move on to Nike. You know what I mean? Adidas, maybe. 4 seconds left.
3, 2.
Split ways with BBB, man. Split ways with BBB. You know what's crazy is the BBB, and I'm not talking about their brand, the Better Business Bureau actually gives BBB an F rating as a business. That means people aren't receiving their sneakers and everything. But Lonzo, my final takeaway is I hope he becomes a player that we all thought he was going to be after college. So next subject, we got a Supreme North Face collaboration, spring summer 2019, hardly looking like a spring summer drop.
Starting the timer
already? Oh, that quickly. All right, so we got a very colorful teal, purple, yellow. This is hardly a collaboration in my opinion. What kind of... Like, Supreme North Face is probably one of the most anticipated collaborations there is when it comes to streetwear. And you come with this? It looks like a regular North Face jacket, North Face sweatshirt and everything, just with Supreme on the chest. And you guys have heard me say this in my Supreme pickups, hype talks and everything. I'm off Supreme. If you guys see me with the hype Supreme piece, I'm not talking about the USPS one that I'm rocking sometimes. You guys can have the piece. That means if you guys see me at Sneaker Con or at, you know, Complex Con, I will give you the t-shirt off my back if I am rocking a box logo tee. But 15 seconds left. Supreme Summer 2019. Not worth copying. I'm going to have to give it a...
Bruh.
Cut that. We also got a... Oh, man. Johnny's favorite sneaker. One of my favorite sneakers, too. The Shattered Backboard 3.0s are dropping officially October 4th. A lot of people were timer starting. Man, we got a October 4th. These are crazy. Same color blocking as the regular bread ones, but a nice bone midsole, meaning it's cream, not like a pure white. And I like that they're not doing the patented leather. For a little bit, people were saying that the patented leather is going to be released in the Shattered Backboard 3.0s, but these are all regular leather, it looks like. And I'm looking at them right now. These are clean. I think... some people were saying they're going to be limited to 30,000 pairs, but now I hope they're limited, but obviously not limited to the point that their resale is more than $500. But these are clean. One of my favorite releases coming up. These Travis Scott's. A lot of people are asking me, 10 seconds left. These might be the shoe of the year. Might be the shoe of the year. It's a toss-up between those and the Travis Scott's. But speaking of resale value, man, have you guys seen the resale value on the Sean Weatherspoons lately? It is over $1,100 easily after he announced that he has split ways with Nike and that he is no longer in contract with them. The Sean Weatherspoons are now minimum $1,100 on StockX. This is at least in a size 8.5 or 9. That is insane. You guys remember that trade that I recently did with for the Red Octobers? I valued the Sean Weatherspoons, the ones that I wore, at only $400. Basically, I got bopped on the trade, but that was my fault. But I valued them at $400, and now they are $1,100 after Sean Weatherspoon says he is no longer with Nike, which is crazy, man. I know he has a lot. It really didn't seem like it was a good fit, Nike and Sean Weatherspoon, because, you know, obviously Nike's so corporate, and Sean, you know, he's more... for the people. So, but anyways, the Shattered Backboard 3.0s, you know, I don't want to speak too soon. A lot of people don't like it when I speak too soon on the sneaker of the year. Even before they come out, people do not like when I give my opinion, but they might be the sneaker of the year. I guess we're just going to talk about some sneakers right now. I got to bring up the Fear of God Nike ones. Jerry, please do not release those colorways that have been surfacing lately, the rainbow sherbet ones. Just keep it how it is, you know, with the black pair and the bone pair. Don't water down the Fear of God Nikes, please. What do you guys think? Have you guys seen those colors that they're saying are going to release, like the teal and the purple? They look like when Apple first came out with the Mac computers, with like the pastel computers. That's what the colorways look like. Please do not release those, man. Did you guys know the reason why they are so comfortable is there's a technology in the cushioning? At first I thought it was just Zoom Air, but there's actually something in the insole called Strobel. It's like a basically an extra layer of cushioning or something like that, and they were testing out this technology in the Fear of God ones for the first time, but they didn't actually announce it. So it's this thing called Strobel. If you actually cut the Fear of God ones, you will see this extra cushioning layer that I'm talking about, but they are actually going to be putting the Strobel cushioning in the new Kevin Durant's, the new KD's, but they were testing them out in the Fear of God ones. So if you guys like how bouncy the Fear of God ones are, then you're going to like how the new KD's fit. So, but anyways, that's pretty much it. Last announcements, Project Goods will be this Friday, 8 a.m. I say get on there early. You know, I want everybody to get exactly what they want. A lot of vintage stuff. Got a lot of sneakers. Got a lot of clothing. And Ralph's going to be adding his stuff. Tan's going to be adding his stuff. And it's going to be one for the record books. Also, we're going to be doing a Q&A in the next episode. So down below in the comments, let me know if you guys have any questions for me or the Hype Talk crew. You know, I'll definitely answer them in the next episode, maybe 5 questions, and we're also going to be shouting you out and everything. And that's pretty much it. Winners of the Air Force One giveaway will be announced soon. The directions for that giveaway will be in the description box below. I just want to give a huge shout out to you guys for still rocking with the channel. We are about to hit 1 million subscribers. All right, guys, that's pretty much it, man. I'm signing out. Episode 2 of the... We do not have a name yet. Maybe we call it Beanie Talk. I don't know. When I saw Beanie Talk, man, whoever that was, Beanie Talk, let me know. We'll send you guys a prize. But Beanie Talk, I kind of like Beanie Talk. That's pretty much it. Links in the description box below to the Uniqlo t-shirts. Travis Scott's will be for sale this Friday. Cause hat, shout out to Bobby the Plug. I'm out. Hold on. Let's play that Richie Lee one more time. It's called H-Town. Not finished yet, but you guys gotta let me know. Do you guys want this to release? I can't do with the flying. No Richie Lee, call it 1-800-555-8777 to request this. I can't do with the flying. All right, guys. Huh? Song of the show? Hold on, let me repeat that. Let me see the vibes of it. Maybe. Does it got a good vibe? Shout out my cousin friend H-Town. All right, guys, I'm out. I cannot do it the same. Woo!